Hey foodsters, I hope you all are safe and sound. Today we'll be discussing the mistakes to avoid while making rasgullas. So foodsters, I can guarantee you if you avoid these mistakes, your rasgulla will be soft and spongy at home. You might have faced issue while preparing rasgullas at home. Sometimes they are hard, sometimes they are not spongy. So we'll be talking about those errors which we need to avoid. Today we are preparing rasgullas by using 1 liter of milk and we'll be preparing around 20 rasgullas by this. Let's see how. I have this 1 liter of milk. We'll start boiling. We'll be talking about the tips of halwais while making rasgullas. What happens, like sometimes rasgullas get shrink. So we'll be giving you a tip how to keep it intact and spongy. We need to keep on stirring this milk because we don't want that it gets sticks on the bottom of the pan. So we'll keep on stirring. So once you see the milk have started boiling, at that point we need to turn off the heat. Now on the other side, we'll be preparing the chhena. For that, I have 1/2 cup of water. In this, I'll add vinegar, 2 tablespoons. You can also use lemon juice instead of vinegar. We are using vinegar here. We'll show you the process. But for using lemon juice, you need to filter the lemon juice. Because if we don't filter, what happens? The pulp enters in rasgulla and that doesn't taste good. Here we are using water with vinegar because we want to use the diluted form of vinegar into the milk. Milk has also released at heat for 2 to 3 minutes. At this stage we need to add this diluted form of vinegar slowly and steadily and then mix it to take out the chhena. We need to avoid adding vinegar or lemon juice in the hot milk. So we need to ensure that we release the heat of the milk in the first stage and then add the mixture. The best option is to use cow milk because cow milk is low in fat and it makes the rasgulla much softer and spongy. As cow milk is low in fat, so it is beneficial for high BP patients and also for cholesterol patients. Now you can see the milk has started turning into chhena and after 3 to 4 minutes the entire chhena will get separated from milk. When the chhena and water is entirely separated, we'll strain the water by using cotton or muslin cloth. Foodsters, please watch this video till end because in the end I'm sharing the halwai trick, which is a very important trick to follow to avoid the shrink of rasgullas. We will wash it 2 to 3 times to release the soury taste and then squeeze it and hang it. So let's proceed now. We'll talk about the second mistake. Don't hang it for more than 15 minutes to retain the moisture. The second mistake which we need to take care is while hanging this chena. If we hang this chena for more than 15 minutes, what happens? The chena gets dried up and as a result, the rasgullas doesn't become soft and spongy. At this stage, you can see our chena is soft. We will go ahead and knead it like a smooth dough. At this stage, we will be adding refined flour, 1 teaspoon or corn flour, and we will knead it again to make it smooth. While making the balls, you can do one thing, you can oil your hands well and then start making the balls. I have prepared around 20 rasgullas. You can see the small balls in this plate. Now this part is done. We'll start with the syrup now. For the syrup, I have 1 cup of sugar. In this, I'll add 6 times water. When the water starts boiling, at this stage we'll add the rasgullas. You can see I have added all the rasgullas in the syrup and will keep on boiling for 5 minutes. Slowly and steadily the rasgullas will take its shape, it will become bigger. In the middle of this, we will cover it with a lid. Now we need to boil it again by covering the lid for another 5-10 minutes. In the middle of it, we'll uncover the lid and then turn the rasgullas so that it get boiled from all the sides. This is the time to share the halwai trick. We will take a bowl filled with ice cubes. We will also add one big bowl of chilled water in it. At this stage, we need to bring all the rasgullas, I mean to say boiling rasgullas, to this chilled water. What happens here when we put the boiling rasgullas in chilled water, the cooking process gets completed and the rasgullas takes its own shape. The third mistake which we need to take care, that is while boiling the rasgullas. What happens if we boil the rasgullas and keep it and turn the flame off? What happens? The rasgullas become harder. So what we need to follow in this, we need to follow the halwai style, that is pulling out the rasgullas from the hot syrup and dipping in this cold chilled water. After keeping the rasgullas for around 3 to 4 minutes in the chilled water, we will go ahead and squeeze all the rasgullas and take out of it in a pan or a bowl. You can see while taking out the rasgullas out of this chilled water, this shape of rasgullas remains intact. It remains spongy. It also remains soft and it's not going to shrink anymore. The syrup has also turned normal in temperature. We will add this on the rasgullas. So our rasgulla is done. One step, we need to add 1 teaspoon of rose water to make it more aromatic. If we can take care of these 3 mistakes, then I can guarantee that our rasgullas will be soft and spongy. So foodsters, this is all done from my end. You can serve this rasgullas to your friends and family at home. No need to bring it from outside. You can store in the refrigerator and have it. If you like the recipe, foodsters, please don't forget to subscribe, share and like. Thank you so much.